we will see what they have in store for the Toros. Third down, big chance to make an impact on defense. Once again, it's a man in motion for Torres. And that brings up fourth down. It's a three and out for the Torres offense. Ever dangerous. Waiting for your Highlanders. Trying to see if we can get a number on the Torres punter. We will go ahead and get that right now. It's number 24. 24, Alan Avila. Newhouse unable to go ahead and return that one as it takes a Torres roll down to about the 33. The punt from Alan Avila takes a Torres bounce to about the 33. That's where your Highlanders will start their first offensive series of the game. So ladies and gentlemen, now we get to see the Highlanders go ahead and come on out. Their first try at the offense. We will see how they do. In at quarterback is Noah Zamora. We'll see how Zamora operates the Highlander defense. It's a handoff to Gustavo Castañeda. Castañeda is going to take some tacklers with him. Handoff is to Gustavo Castañeda. Flag on the play. See what happens as we keep our eye on the head referee, Scott Hammock, in the white hat. Had been pushed out of bounds by Amani Sua. It's going to be a personal foul against the Highlanders. Personal foul against the Highlander offense. It's going to move the Highlanders. First down. So then here are the Highlanders. They're going to try it one more time. Zamora in at quarterback with a running back to his left. It's a keeper by Zamora. Quarterback keeper by Noah Zamora. Zamora able to pick up about one or two. And of course, your Highlanders coming off last Thursday's 54-7 win against the Fresno High Warriors. So second and 14. Zamora and a running back who appears to be Castañeda. Looking to throw. Going deep. Trying to find Azir Newhouse and incomplete. The pass intended for Azir Newhouse, incomplete. Amani Sua on the coverage for Torres. He's up there down. So Sua had Azir Newhouse's number on that occasion. He's up there down for the Highlanders. See what the Highlander offense has up their sleeves for this third and long, third and 14 from the 29. Zamora in the pistol. Now Zamora is his back, evading the tackle. And it's a bounce back pass that is complete to Jazz Bowen. Is complete to Jazz Boylan. And that's the McLane Highlanders. First down! So a ricochet. finds his hands, and the Highlanders keep the drive alive into Torres territory. Ball on to Torres, 48. That was quite a good play. Sometimes in the game of football, you need the help of Lady Luck. That sure was a great play for the Highlanders. New set of downs, ball is on the Torres 48. Samora, handing off. Handoff is to Castaneda. Handoff to Gustavo Castaneda. Loss of one, second down. So not much going there for Gustavo. Gustavo had himself quite the game last time around. One carry for 24 yards and one touchdown against the Fresno High Warriors. Noah Zamora in the meantime, 5 for 13 from the quarterback position, 69 yards and one touchdown. On the ground, he had 5 carries, 34 yards, and one touchdown on the ground. So here we go, second down. Zamora once again in the pistol with his running back. It's a quick draw to 21. At number 21 for the Highlanders is Juju Scott. Pass complete to Juju Scott. Loss of one brings up third down. So not much working on the quick draw pass to Juju Scott. The sensational freshman. And that's going to bring up third down for the Highlanders. The ball is right at midfield. Samora once again, awaiting the snap. We've got something going on at the line. That play seemed to have broken from the beginning. Line on the play. It'll be an illegal procedure related against your Highlanders. Highlanders travel 5 back. The ball is at 45. Going down. 17. Just call it Aaron Long for your Highlander offense. Again, we thank you so much for being with us here on the broadcast. Playing Highlander football here on Highlander Highlands, a production of the students of McLane's Art Venture Academy. I thank all our students. I want to thank all our advisors, their advisors, our administration for being able to bring you Highlander football live on YouTube. Pleasure to be able to bring the game to you. We've got ourselves a timeout. Timeout call on the field. Timeout McLane. So we've got a timeout and we're going to take a very quick break. You are watching McLane Highlander football on Highlander Highlights. Stadium, McLane Highlander football and Highlander Highlights. We'll see how the Highlanders respond to a third down. Samora drops back, now rolls out to his right, looking for the open man. Airing it out and incomplete. Intended for Jaron Scott. Pass intended to Jaron Scott. Incomplete. Brings up fourth down. So that brings up a fourth down for the Highlanders. To see who goes back deep for Torres. As of now, it looks like they elect to send no one back. Well, actually, it looks like it's not a punt formation. The rest of our eyes deceive us. and he moves a little backwards and is awaiting. That is number three, Jaden Turner, who waits for 2 minutes. The punt from Jaden Turner. We'll be down by your Highlanders. Right in front. Punt on the 30. So it's 30 where Torros is the Torres High School, the 2-2. Their last game, a 35-14 win against the Roosevelt Rough Riders in Madera. Here we go, it is a handoff. First run from scrimmage, and that is number three. Handoff is to Joseph Bass. Quickly met by Jazz Boylan. No gain, second down. So it's a second down for Torres. Joseph Bass. He had himself quite a game in the last one. 13 carries for 101 yards. Two rushing touchdowns. Soriano back to pass. He's going to be on the move. There goes Jose Soriano. It's going to be more than enough for the first. Then he goes on the run. Still evades the second tackle. And Soriano is finally pushed out of bounds into Highlander territory. Jose Soriano with the quarterback run. Pushed out of bounds by Demetrius Simon into Highlander territory. That's a Torres first down. So Soriano showing what he can do on the ground. Last game he had 4 carries for 33 yards and 1 rushing touchdown himself. We've got a handoff. The handoff is to, and able to come up with the number, appears to be number 3. Handoff is to Joseph Bass. Again, 8, second and 2. A wee bit difficult, might we say, to check out the Torres numbers. Wearing a white jersey with a silver helmet and silver numbers as well. Up here for the press box. We will go ahead and do our best to bring those numbers to you. Hand off once again to Joseph Bass. Shorter the line again, brings up third down. Brings up a third down for the Toros. They've got a man in motion, 2 men in motion. Avila lining up as a tight end. And Soriano awaiting the pass, and he's going to get dropped. Quarterback sack. That's 3 Highlanders combining for the sack. That'll bring up fourth down. So 3 Highlander tacklers, one of them being Gregory Ramirez. Bring down Soriano. That brings up fourth down. Brings up what will be a punting situation for Torres. Alan Avila back to the front for the Torres. Ready to receive for your high. Does he? Newhouse. We will see what Mr. Desir Newhouse has in store. Avila is going to punt it away, and Newhouse won't be able to return that one into the end zone for a touchback. Punt travels into the end zone. Your Highlander offense will start it off from the 20. And so the Highlanders will start it off from the 20. We're going to take a very quick break and come back to you with the action. You're watching McLane Highlander football. Highlander Highlights, a production of the students of the Art Venture Academy. Stadium, second offensive drive for the Highlanders. It's going to be a handoff. The handoff is to TJ McMillan III. Tackle made by Brian Gonzalez for Torres. Gain of one. Second and nine. So TJ McMillan III, the senior, on the ground. McMillan had himself in the previous game against Fresno High. 8 carries for 95 yards and 1 touchdown. Great to see him on the field once more. Second down for the Highlander offense. It's the quarterback in the shotgun, and now it's Jaden Turner. So once again, great to see him back. Turner completes to McMillan III. Pass is complete to TJ McMillan III. Multiple Torres tacklers, among them Ian Cortez Lopez, brings up third down. So it's great to see Jaden Turner back in there for your Highlanders. He sat out the last game due to injury, just watched it from the sidelines, and now he is back and has been given the keys to the car. The car, of course, being the McLane Highlander offense. So man in motion for the Highlanders, it's Juju Scott. And there goes the freshman. Watch him go. Watch him spin. Juju Scott with the run, moving the chains for the Highlanders. Juju Scott on the run. That's a McLane Highlander. First down. So Juju Scott, the fabulous freshman, able to turn the legs enough for the Highlander front. It's a first and 10. Ball on the 36. Ball on the 36. So now it's Noah Zamora back in at quarterback, and it's going to be a quarterback keeper. And Zamora is going to move backwards. It's Noah Zamora with quarterback keeper. Multiple Torres tacklers, one of them, Alan Avila. Loss of three. Second back. So nothing going for Zamora there. Comes back after getting the play from the sideline. Zamora throwing wise went 5 for 13, 69 yards in the air, and one touchdown pass. We'll see how he's able to replicate that performance. He is going to be on the move again, and there he goes. Short of the first down marker. Last play of the first, and that sure was a quick first. That run by Noah Zamora will take us to the end of the quarter. After one, it's your McLane Highlanders and the Torres Toros yet to score. So, 0-0 here at McLane Stadium, ladies and gentlemen. We're gonna take a small break, but we're coming right back. You're watching McLane Highlander Football on Highlander Highlights, a production of the students of McLane's Art Venture Academy. Stadium. The Highlanders have a third and four. Third and four from the 42. Looking to once again cross the lines for another Highlander first down. It's a man in motion. It's Desir Newhouse. And watch him run. This time, however, they're going to contain him. And they sure did. It brings up a fourth. And that first to Desir Newhouse. Loss of two on the play. Alan Avila, one of the tacklers for Torres. Brings up fourth down. Well, I'll tell you what, folks. That was a very quick moving first quarter. It came and it went in the blink of an eye. And we'll see how the Highlanders operate on fourth down. From what we can tell here, it's the same play again. Turner looking like he's ready to quarterback, and he's going to punt it away. And once again, no Torres returner back on the punt. The punt from Jaden Turner. So Turner able to punt it away. Torres will start their next offensive drive from the 35. Torres will start it off first and 10 from their own 35. So Torres offense, once again, in the spotlight. Jose Soriano operating at quarterback. Handoff is going to be to the running back. That running back is Amani Sua. Hand off is to Amani Sua. Sua able to pick up a couple of yards on that play. Brings up second down. Personnel change for the Toros. They have two wide receivers to Soriano's left. One to his right. Soriano throwing. That's number 13 making the catch. Pass is complete to Demetri Onila. Post the Highlanders to bring him down. That's a first down for the Toros. So the pass complete to Demetri Onila into Highlander territory, and a new set of downs for Toros. The ball placed at the 40. The handoff once again is to Amani Sua. Sua is the ball carrier. One of the tacklers for your Highlanders, Gustavo Castañeda. Amani Sua, ladies and gentlemen, had himself quite the game last week against the Roosevelt Roughriders. 23 carries, 185 yards, and one touchdown. So, knocking on the door, 200 yards, was Amani Sua for the Toros. It's a handoff once more. And third time is the charm, Sua. Amani Sua with the carry. Moves the chains for Toros, it's a first down. So new life for Torres, courtesy of the 6'2", 215-pound junior running back, Amani Sua. So first down for Torres. Handoff is to Amani Sua. And it looks like they might just elect to feed him for most of the night. Amani Sua, the ball carrier. Gain of six, second and four. 6 yards for Sua. 4 yards away from the first down marker. Also 4 yards away from the red zone. As we just mentioned, this young man is a workhorse. We'll go ahead and we'll keep our eye out for him. Jose Soriano operating in the shotgun. It's a pass play. Soriano looking deep. Touchdown, Torres. The pass complete from Jose Soriano to Demetrio Nila. And that's a Toros touchdown. Just needed a little bit of visual confirmation on the number, but it is Demetrio Nila. On to attempt the extra point, Brian Barriga. So Brian Barriga, the Torres kicker, who went 5 for 5 in point after attempts last time around. He misses this one, and 0 for 1 on the night, as just heard by the great Ed Schoaf. The point after touchdown is no good. 8:24 left in the half. It's the Torres Toros 6, your McLane Highlanders, yet to score. So Torres in the lead, sans the PAT. That's 6 for them. We'll come right back. You're watching McLane Highlander Football and Highlander Highlights, the production of McLane's Art Venture Academy. Back to McLane Stadium, and Alan Avila is going to keep the kick away from the Highlander returners. That's Zeke Mendibles on the return. The kick is returned by Zeke Mendibles, taking it out to about the 39. That's where your Highlander offense will start the next offensive drive. Offense operating with Jaden Turner. Jaden Turner to Desir Newhouse, and he's got the room, he's got the space, still on his feet, and looking to push his way to the first down marker. The pass is complete to Desir Newhouse from Jaden Turner. Good enough for another Highlanders. First down! That final little push by Mr. Excitement, Desir Newhouse, able to go ahead and pick up the new set of downs. Ball on the 49 for the Highlanders, who are looking to answer the Torres touchdown. Jaden Turner operating in the shotgun. It's a handoff to TJ McMillan III, and McMillan III is going to be quickly met. Handoff is to T.J. McMillan III. Joseph Bass and Amani Sua, the tacklers for Torres. No gain, second down. So the ball remains on the 49. We will see how the Highlanders come on back. We've got two wide receivers to the left of Turner, and two to his right, one running back, low snap. Turner going to the air, going to the air. Touchdown, Highlanders! 51-yard touchdown! touchdown from Jaden Turner to Nazir Newhouse. And ladies and gentlemen, once again, Lady Luck doing the favor for your Highlanders. What was a near interception by the Toros ends up in the hands of Nazir Newhouse. Ariel Valadez on for the PAT. And here's Valadez, who last time around went 6 for 8 with point after attempts. And we've got ourselves a timeout by the Highlanders. Timeout call on the field. Timeout, McLane. And that is one of those plays that you are going to be able to watch again and again and again. Go ahead and save it on your phone, save it on your tablet, wherever you may. It was a surefire Torres interception. And somehow, some way, it ends up in the hands of Mr. Excitement, Desir Newhouse. We'll take a quick break. We're coming right back. Welcome back to McLane Stadium. You're watching Highlander Football and Highlander Highlights, a production of the Art Venture Academy students. And as we were, it's Ariel Valadez, the senior kicker, out of the hold of Noah Zamora. We'll see where the PAT goes. Awaiting the snap, the kick, and it's good. Point after touchdown is good. 6:51 left in the half. It's your McLane Highlanders 7, the Torres Toros 6. And Valadez is good for the PAT. Your Highlanders take a 1-point lead here in the first half. We'll come right back to you once again. Highlander football and Highlander highlights. Don't go anywhere. Back at McLane Stadium, Ariel Valadez about to kick it into the McLane Stadium side. And Molina will be the returner. He is going to take the kickoff. Looks like he's got some speed, and he's going to be met by multiple Highlander tacklers. Molina on the return. Multiple Highlanders on the side. Torres Toros will start it off from their own 27. So here we are, 1-point Highlander lead, 7-6, on the miraculous by Desir Newhouse. To the house for 6. Get ready for that phrase, folks. You'll be hearing it many, many times this season. So here comes Torres, Jose Soriano, their quarterback, and one running back, that's Amani Sua. And it is going to be a handoff. Still going, still churning. The handoff is to Joseph Bass. Gain of 2, 2nd and 8. So Bass this time around. 13 carries, 101 yards, and 2 touchdowns. In the last game against the Rough Riders, two Sorianos left. He got one. He finds one.
Defense! 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 Defense!
Store. The ball is on the 24. The Torres 4 yards away from the red zone. It's going to be a handoff and he is stopped. The handoff is sniffed out by Zeke Mendibles. Handoff is to Amani Sua. Loss of two. Zeke Mendibles on the stop. Brings up fourth down. So that brings up a fourth down for Torres. All early indications would point that the offense is staying out there. And they will go for it. We will see what they do. They send the running back in motion. So Soriano does go back to throw. Soriano to Mila. Down the one. First and goal, Torres. So the Highlanders unable to get the third down stop. That's Demetrio Mila taking it all the way down to the one. More than likely that we will see is a running play to three, and it does. Touchdown, Torres. Joseph Bass from 1 yard out. There's Joseph Bass with the touchdown. Once again, Torres jump out to the lead. 12-7, point after ending. Torres will move to. Left in the half. It's your McLane Highlanders 7 and Torres Torres 12. So the Highlanders catch a break there. Torres could have gone up 14-7. However, it's 12-7 with 2:35 left in the first half. We thank you so much for joining us. You are watching McLane Highlander Football and Highlander Highlights, a production of the students of McLane's Art Venture Academy. here in McLane Stadium. It's the Highlanders on the return, and this time it is Desir Newhouse. Able to take a crack at it. It's three Torres tacklers on the stop. Desir Newhouse on the return. A trio of Torres tacklers on the stop. Ball will be placed at the 39. That's where your Highlander offense will set up shop. And so the Highlander offense, starting from the 39, looking to respond to the Torres touchdown. It's been a close one. It's been a close one indeed. Turner, the quarterback, McMillan in motion. Turner on the run, he's got pressure from behind. Airing it out. Pass complete from Jaden Turner to Juju Scott. Enough for another McLane Highlander. First down. What a pass to Juju Scott in coverage. Comes down with it into Thorne's territory. New life for the Highlanders. Give Scott credit. The 5'9", 140 freshman is able to make that contested catch in coverage. Let's see if Jaden Turner has any tricks in the bag. McMillan the third bounces off two already. There goes McMillan the third. He's still going, McMillan the third. Taking it into the red zone. TJ McMillan the third on the run. Another McLane Highlander. First down. What a run from TJ McMillan the third. Three ball machine. 16 yards run on the play. And into the red zone. Ball on the 11. Ball is on the 11 for the Highlanders, and they are putting up just the most awesome response drive that you could put up. Turner to the air! Touchdown! Highlanders! Jaden Turner, complete to Demetrius Simon! Turner to Simon for six. Ariel Valadez on to attempt the PAT. Noah Zamora to hold. So here's Valadez on to attempt the point after. Kick is up and good. Point after is up and good. 58 seconds left in the half. It's your McLane Highlanders 14. Torres Torres 12. That's how you concoct an answer, ladies and gentlemen. 14-12 Highlanders over the Torres. We'll come right back. You're watching McLane Highlander football on Highlander Highlights. The production of the students of McLane's Art Venture Academy. But it's 50 seconds. Soriano back to pass. Soriano feeling the heat. able to complete it to Demetrio Nila. Pass complete from Soriano to Nila. Timeout call on the field. Timeout, Torres. And so after the completion to Demetrio Nila, Torres stops the clock and they'll talk it over. In the meantime, we'll come right back, ladies and gentlemen, right here. McLane Highlander football and Highlander highlights. Is complete from Soriano to Moreno. And just like that, it's a quick strike from Jose Soriano to Jesus Moreno. Toros knocking on the door. Highlander defense looking to respond. Once again, we will come right back. Highlander football and Highlander highlights is a production of the students of McLane's Art Venture Production Academy. Stadium, ladies and gentlemen, Torres wants to try to get the touchdown before the end of the half. It's a screen pass to Amani Sula. The pass is complete to Amani Sula, wrapped up by Cedric Hughes. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll stick around with you during this timeout. So thrilled to have you along for the ride. Make sure those seat belts are buckled because it's going to be a good one, especially leading into the second half. Of course, everything hinging on what Torres can do with 19 seconds on the clock. Probably try to take a few quick strikes in the end zone, seeing if they could go ahead and at least try to level this game or come close to being level in the first half. Score update from Levi's Stadium. In the fourth quarter, it's the San Francisco 49ers leading the New York Giants 23-12. And so, you just heard that Thursday Night Football on right now, but of course we've got our own Thursday Night Football right here. And let me tell you, it's a good one. Torres looking to get into the end zone before the end of the first half. So Soriano dropping back. Touchdown Torres. Touchdown completion from Soriano to Nila. seeing what the Toros decide to do. And all 5 points to the field goal for two. Once more. Toros will be going for two. Highlander Nation, you know what to do. So here we go. Torres going 4-2. Highlanders got the stop the last time around. And this time we have a delayed game. Delayed game levied against the Torres offense. We'll move it back to the 8-yard line. So that kind of throws a wrench into the Torres plans. Or will they elect to still go for two? Or attempt to kick the extra point? Toros 18, your McLane Highlanders 14. And so, for the second time, point conversion try. Toros leading by four. We'll come right back in a few seconds. McLane Highlander football on Highlander Highlights.
My name is Lizbeth.
And I'm Suzette.
And here are this week's updates from Highlander Highlights. Seniors, need help creating your FSA ID? Come into the counseling center either during lunch or after school, and a counselor will help. Make sure you check your Fresno Unified email. There is a YouTube video with a step-by-step process on how to create an FSA ID. An FSA ID must be completed if you want your off-campus pass application to get approved. Once you have created it, please take a screenshot and send it to your counselor. Attention, anyone who is interested in attending Fresno State. We have two Fresno State ambassadors. Rose Chang and Angela Matthews are here to help you with your application, eligibility requirements, or anything Fresno State questions. They will be located in the counseling office every Tuesday from 8:30 a.m. to 3:30 p.m. Please request to see them by emailing them, signing up in the counseling office, or speak to Counselor Vasquez. If you're interested in being a rising scholar, your application must be submitted by 9/21. You can access the application through the QR code in your acceptance letter. Fresno City College Advisors will be here every Tuesday. Please come prepared. Counselors can also help you submit during lunch.
Updates from leadership. Don't forget, this week is our blackout game versus Torres at home. Come get your wristband to the game on Thursday during lunch. Juniors and seniors, you can get your wristbands at the stage. And freshmen and sophomores, you can get yours in front of the library. You must be eligible to get a wristband, and the non-privileged list will be posted on the attendance window by your ID number during lunch on Thursday. Make sure to head to the stage this Friday during lunch for a Unity Lunch Tour celebrating Hispanic Heritage Month. This Friday is also Soccer Jersey Day, so make sure that you wear your favorite soccer jersey to school. If you're interested in running for homecoming royalty, please come to a mandatory meeting today, Wednesday, September 20th, right after school in AC 102.
Our first feature story this week is all about the Walk Like Mad event that took place at Gettysburg Park in Clovis. Thanks to Mara, Key Club, and Art Venture, McLane had over 80 volunteers for this annual event. Here is the story.
Hey Highlanders, it's Hunter, and today we're at the Walk Like a Mad event, and we are here with
Tiffany,
and we're going to be interviewing people on how they want to prevent drunk driving and people driving under the influence.
I'm Chief Carrillo, Rick Carrillo with the Lindsay Police Department.
And what brings you out here today?
We want to support MAD the best that we can. You know, we've come across these collisions, these cases throughout our career, and it's always very, very emotional for all involved, to include our staff, and we want to make every effort to support them any way we can.
And what does MAD stand for?
Mothers Against Drunk Driving.
And what does that mean to you?
It's a mothers that came together many, many years ago, tired of dealing with the effects of drunk driving, the losses that they've sustained, and they gathered themselves to combat and to lobby and to do their best to prevent it.
And how do you think, in what ways do you think we could prevent that?
By getting the word out there, publicizing our events, publicizing what's going on, the enforcement details, and I truly think that raising the stakes and making the punishment steeper than what they are, that's where people learn when you hit the pocketbook, or they realize that it's going to be jail time and not just a citation.
All right, thank you for being in
the
interview.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Hi, Highlanders. I'm here with
Yolanda Quadros
and Sheila Harvey.
Okay, I'm going to be asking you guys some questions. So why are you guys here today?
I'm here because each year Walk Like Mad has an event where the community comes together to bring awareness about the dangers of drinking and driving and to honor those who have lost their lives to drunk drivers. And my daughter was killed at the age of 14 by a drunk driver right before Christmas. And every time I hear of a collision and a DUI, my heart just drops, and I don't want families to go through this anymore. So we're trying to get the message out that it's not worth it to drink or drive. If you're under the age, you know, don't do it. And if you're over, if you drink, do it safely. Have a sober driver, have a plan to get home. There, too many precious lives have been taken. Thank you.
I'm here because my son was killed by a drunk driver on his way home. And I Walk Like Mad, and all my family and friends, we do it to let everyone know it's unsafe to drink and drive. Do not use drugs, do not use pills or anything. No drinking and driving.
Thank you. So what does MAD stand for?
Mothers Against Drunk Driving. But we are not just mothers, we're brothers, we're fathers, we're friends and family. A lot of people get affected each time a person loses their life to a drunk driver. As you heard in the ceremony, some whole families, it was a family of two, a family of five, so many people. And it was just my daughter, but that's a piece of me.
And what's an advice you guys would like to give to drivers out there?
Please do not drink and drive or use anything. Call someone if you need someone to pick you up. Use an Uber, whatever it is.
Thank you so much. This is Tiff.
And Hunter.
And that's a wrap for the Walk of Mad. Now back to the studio.
Wow, that was very powerful. Thanks, guys.
Our next feature story is all about Club Rush. And thanks to all the Highlanders who showed up for the event.
Today is Club Rush, Friday 15th. And I'm going to be asking students what clubs are being represented. Me and my team are going to be asking clubs. So I kind of think I wanted to start off with the bank club, bank crew. I'm not sure what their title is, but let's go find out, okay? It's Melanie, right?
Yes,
Melanie. So Melanie, I'm with bank crew, right? And could you tell us a little bit about what your club does, or not club, but organization?
Yeah. So, okay, so US Bank is an organization in which we offer students the opportunity to make bank accounts here on campus. So anyone who is on campus can actually make a bank account and actively make transactions. Our whole team is in the bank, actually. We have first period, second, third, fifth, sixth, and seventh available. So at any time you guys want to go, you guys get permission and head to the bank. We'll walk you through the steps of opening an account and all the benefits you get from it. And there's always, there's always two workers in each period. So you have a wide variety of help.
No first period.
So can you tell me about your club and what your club is?
My club is BSU. It's the Black Student Union of McLane. And it represents like inclusivity for Black students, you know?
What made you join your club?
What made me join the club was that I like being surrounded with people who look like me. So, you know, and it's kind of underrepresented here. So yeah, my club has to offer a lot of stuff, being like in touch with a community, like, you know, of people who look like you, and, you know, just, I don't know, just vibes.
Hey, thank you.
Yeah.
Hi, my name is Noah, and I'm here with
Miss Ketchum.
Okay, and what is this club all about?
Art.
Can you give me more?
Yeah, so we meet on Tuesdays and Thursdays at lunch. Grab your lunch, come on up. Sometimes we watch like art cartoons, but we also eventually will have face painting access for you. That's kind of better than everyone else's. And we also will have like during Halloween, like blood and effects that you can mess around with. So it's kind of just a little experimentation in art one or basic things. But also if you need something from me, like you're like, hey, can I get copy paper, coloring sheets or something like that? And you want to talk about something in particular about art, I'll be there Tuesday, Thursdays at lunch.
Okay, and if there was something for you to add to your club, like to change, what would it be?
I would like to be able to get us to do more murals as a club, especially like after hours or like weekends or something, and that would mean we'd need some funding because I think it would be really cool on campus to have murals that were made just by the students, not by like outside sources. So, yeah.
And did you make this right here?
Yes, I made this poster. It's just some doodles. We did it in a class, so I'm just kind of having fun while I sit out here.
Okay, thank you.
So the bell just rang, and we just got done interviewing a few groups who are participating in Club Rush, and I hope that we gave you guys some insight and maybe some encouragement to actually join a club, because it's really good to be a part of to be involved in high school and to do things. But it's also really hot. And man, thanks though. Okay.
Now here's Jasmine Jordan with sports.
This week we have girls volleyball taking on Roosevelt this Thursday in the McLane gym. JV starts at 4:30 p.m. and varsity starts at 5:30 p.m. We also have a water polo match against Chowchilla this Thursday with matches starting at 3:30 p.m. at the McLane Aquatic Center. Don't forget our football team will be taking on Torres this Thursday, with JV starting at 4:30 p.m. and varsity starting at 7 p.m. We will be live broadcasting the game this week on our YouTube channel, Highlander Highlights. So if you can't make it to the game, then make sure to check out our broadcast. Last week, we went out to the Whiteout game against Fresno High and interviewed some of our players after the game. Here's that story.
Hi, I'm Jasmine, and tonight we're at your McLane Stadium for the Whiteout game with your matchup against Fresno High. So what was the best moment of you tonight?
I think the best moment for me for tonight was when I got my sack. That was like the best part of my day. Well, of every, actually, that's my first sack of the season, so I'm actually happy.
We're winning by 27-7, but it's 0-0 after halftime.
That's amazing. And I have two questions for you tonight. So what was your favorite moment of yourself tonight?
My favorite moment was the punt return, you know, off special teams go work hard. Everybody got their block, and I turned it to six.
And I have a few questions for you tonight. So what was your best moment of yourself tonight?
Best moment of myself? You know what I'm saying? I got the ball, hit a few cuts, took it for like 40, 50. I got hot. I think I'm going to join track next year. But I think that was the best moment of myself.
And I have two questions for you tonight. So how do you feel about the players' hustle and energy tonight?
Very hype game. I'm liking the energy. It makes it a lot easier for the officials out here. So that's great.
And what was your favorite play of tonight's game so far?
Well, because they made me run. One of the dive plays by one of the McLane back. It was a really good play. Touchdown scored on that play.
Okay, thank you. So there you have it, Highlanders. This is your Whiteout game of tonight. So back to Liz and Susan in the studio.
I think you guys did great with that story.
Thank you. I really enjoyed it. But I'm mostly excited about tomorrow's Whiteout game.
See you there.
Okay.
Thanks for watching.
Make sure to tune in next week for more updates from Highlander Highlights.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to McLane Stadium. We're just about ready to get the second half underway. Highlanders football here on Highlander Highlights. Production of the students from McLane's Art Venture Academy. And we buy a few seconds as the teams switch sides. And remember, it's the Highlanders to receive to start the second half. And so just about ready to start the second half here at McLane Stadium. Your Highlanders are set to receive the second half kickoff. On the kicking tee for Torres is Brian Barriga. And back deep as always. This is your new house back deep. And they are going to kick it away from the house. Trying to evade a few tacklers is Demetrius Simon. Demetrius Simon on the return. So Demetrius Simon, not a lot of room to work with. On or about a little bit past the 10. And that's going to be where the Highlanders will start. It's going to be first and 10 for your Highlanders from about the 12. So first offensive play and the second for your Highlanders, down by 4. Noah Samora in the shotgun. TJ McMillan, the third is the back. The pass is complete to Zeke Mendivas, and there he goes. Zeke Mendivas has the number one. Zeke Mendivas still going. Pass complete to Zeke Mendivas. Good enough for another McLane Highlander. First down. Tackled by Joseph Bass for Torres. First and 10 Highlanders from the 43. So the Highlanders get the first down with the completion to Mendivas. It's going to be Zamora on the run. Evades one, evades two. Noah Zamora on the run. Penalty markers on the field. There are penalty markers on the field. We will go ahead and see what the decision is from head referee Scott Hammett. They hold against the Highlanders. The offensive holding against your Highlanders. It's going to move them a little back. So make it a first and 20. Make it a 33. That's what the Highlanders have to work with. Shotgun with McMillan. Low snap. Zamora throwing. Completing to Newhouse. The pass is complete to Jazeer Newhouse. Brings up second down. Jazeer Newhouse taking it close to the original line of scrimmage. Still some yards to travel for the Highlanders. Second and 10. That is a handoff to McMillan. Handoff is to TJ McMillan the third. Demetrio Nila, one of the tacklers for Torres, brings up third down. So a third down situation for the Highlanders. Still looking to keep the drive alive. The ball is on the 43. Zamora, third to his left. Zamora looking to pass, and he does. And it is incomplete, intended for Demetrius Simon. Pass is intended for Demetrius Simon. Brings up fourth down. So unable to find Demetrius Simon on that one. Brings up a fourth down for your Highlander offense. Jaden Turner out there. More than likely will punt. And this time the Toros do send somebody to field the punt. Back deep to return for Torres, Jesus Moreno. And it's Moreno ready to return. A punt from Turner, and it's a sky punt. It's gonna travel out of bounds at about the 38 or 37. And that's where the Torres Toros will start it off. You are watching McLane Highlander Football right here on Highlander Highlights, a production of McLane's Art Venture Academy students. Back here at McLane Stadium, that was a botched snap, bringing up a second down. And that's a fumble again. And we'll see who comes up with it. At the bottom of the pile, second straight fumble for the Toros. And they're able to come up with it. The Toros recover once again on the fumble. Highlander Nation, make some noise. That will be third down. Third down is the money down. You've heard it in many places. The Highlanders looking, needing a stop. Man in motion, which is a mani sua for the Toros. Soriano rolling out to his left. Soriano rolling out to his left. Throwing on the run. And another fumble, and that one travels out of bounds. The pass is complete from Soriano to Lawrence Watson. Good enough for the Toros, first down. And the Highlanders unable to convert on third down on that occasion. Watson taking the pass, bringing it down to the 25. 5 yards away from the red zone. Handoff is to Sua. Thank you.
Thank you.
for the Highlanders.
Go!
Close to the line of game. So the ball residing at the 50. That's where the Toros are now at. Soriano in the shotgun. Personnel moving around. A man in motion, which is Watson. And that play takes us to the end of the quarter. Gentlemen, one more quarter left to play here at McLane Stadium. It's the Toros in the lead, 25-14. You are watching McLane Highlander football on McLane Highlander Highlights, a production of the students of McLane's Art Venture Production Academy. Welcome back to McLane Stadium. as the team switch sides for the fourth and final quarter of play. Torres currently in the lead by 11. So Soriano in at quarterback, in the shotgun. Bass is his running back. Soriano hands it off. And there goes Joseph Bass. Good enough for the first and more. Toros able to bring it down to about the 21. 1 yard out of the red zone. Highlander defense could really use a stop or a turnover right about now. A handoff once again. Two running backs, one of them in motion, and the handoff once again. Chance to make a stop for your Highlanders on third down. Big chance here to make a stop and either limit the Toros to three, or maybe if they decide to go for it, maybe get a fourth down stop. We will see what the Toros decide to do. Soriano under center. Going to be a handoff. And so that handoff just enough. Give the Toros a new set of downs. First and goal from the 10. It's once again Soriano under center. Imani Sue has the ball carry and he'll take it in for the touchdown. Able to add on to their lead. Tack on six. It's a 31-14 point after pending. So the Toros up right now, 8:59 left to work with for the Highlanders. Let's see what they can do. If there's anything left in the tank. You are watching McLane Highlander Football on Highlander Highlights, a production of the students of McLane Art Venture Academy. From Brian Barriga. Demetrius Simon on the return. Able to bring it out just a little past the 35. Down would be very nice right now, but we'll see what Coach Andrew Pancotti has planned for the Highlander offense. Highlanders trying to hang in here with the Torres as Jaden Turner back to pass. He's going to air it out and incomplete, but there is a penalty marker on the field. Interference against the Toros, 15 yards. The Highlanders have the ball at midfield. Juju Scott was interfered with by the Toros. The Highlanders will keep the drive alive. Turner airing it out, and that's a catch. Newhouse. 29 yards to Desiree Newhouse on that reception. The Highlanders, in the words of the great Hank Stram, matriculating the ball down the field. They keep it moving, they keep it going. Staying alive, Turner airing it out. Incomplete. Turner tried to air it out there for Jaron Scott, and the pass is incomplete. Second down for the Highlanders. So it's a second down. Turner in the shotgun, flanked by McMillan to about his left. Now McMillan, the third, goes in motion. Turner will strike again. Turner looking. And it's a Torres interception as Demetri Onila comes up with the ball. Just when it all looked promising for the Highlanders, the Toros able to come up with that interception. And it'll be their football with 8:05 left in the game. Yeah, And again, with all the pieces, we're moving pretty good for your Highlanders. The interception from Demetrio Nila puts the Toros offense back in business once again. So motion from the Toros offense. Soriano handing off. That was a handoff to Amani Sua. We want to apologize, ladies and gentlemen. It's a little difficult to see these Torres numbers as they are white jerseys with silver numbers. So a little difficult to make out. Takes more than a few seconds to come up with the number. And here we go. Soriano with the handoff. Until the Toros come up with just enough to get the first. New set of downs for them. The ball rests on the 30. One wide receiver out to the right. One in motion and one to the left. So it's a second down for Torres. Now trips to the right. Actually, one in the slot. Passes complete to Moreno. And it's the other number two, Demetrius Simon, bringing him down. So it's a third down for the Toros with two men in motion. One of them is Moreno, the other is Nila. A third man was in motion just as I was looking at their names on the roster. And that's going to be a handoff. So the Toros pick up a new set of downs as the time winds down, 4:46 and counting. Ball resting on the 40. So the ball resting on the 40. Once again, motion for the Toros. Soriano with the handoff. The handoff is to Molina. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, your attention please. Attention, McLane Highlander students. Right now is the time to call the video in your mind to pick you up at the conclusion of this game. Once again, I'm McLane Highlander students. Dr. McLane to your audience. If you are at the conclusion of tonight's contest, thank you for your cooperation. So second down, Torres. Soriano will be lining up under center. Two wide receivers to his left. 3:37 and counting down. We've got whistles on the play. And it looks like the Toros are going to take some time to talk it over. 3:35 left in the game. You are watching McLane Highlander Football on Highlander Highlights, a production of the McLane Art Venture Academy. Back, ladies and gentlemen, here at McLane Stadium. Your Highlanders currently down in the scoreboard, 32-14 to the Toros. Handoff is to Amani Sua. So a third down for the Highlanders in a game that looked to be tight in the first quarter. Sorry, first half. And in the second half, the Toros just slightly got away to the point where we are now, 32-14. Nobody said the road in the NYL would be easy, but your Highlanders are still sticking in there, trying to find a way to stop the Torres Toros. And that's Amani Sua on the run. That's going to be more than enough for a Toros first down. Actually, we'll go ahead and stop the presses. Molina. And that one's going to be targeting on the Toros offense, and it's going to move them back. So a game of give or take here. The Toros, who were just about in prime position to score, now find themselves on the 19. Soriano, the quarterback. Sua, the ball carrier, bruising his way through the Highlander defense. That run will keep the clock running, just about ready to hit the 1 minute mark here at McLane Stadium. Second down, ball on the 8, second and 5 to be more exact. Soriano with one running back. And that's a touchdown for the Toros, Joseph Bass, adding on to the Toros lead. 33 seconds left in the game. And here at McLane Stadium, it's been a tale of two halves. First half hanging tight for your Highlanders, and then the second half, the Toros with multiple touchdowns. And we'll see what the call is from the penalty marker. And the flag is waved off. So your McLane Highlanders await the kickoff, what will more than likely be the final kickoff of the game. This is the last Thursday night game for your Highlanders. They'll go back to Friday nights next week, as mentioned, back to Friday nights. We will let you know who the Highlanders will be hosting. Going to be the Roosevelt Rough Riders. That game scheduled for a 7:30 kickoff in the Battle of Cedar. So a little bit of trickery from the Highlanders right there. We will see where the referees place the ball. It would appear to be the 45. So McLane maybe with the chance for at least a consolation touchdown, at least decorate the score. Go down fighting to the last minute, to the last second, such as Highlanders do. Jaden Turner with the pass. The pass is complete to Demetrius Simon. That is going to take us to the timeout, sorry. That's going to take us to the end of the game. So that's the final score tonight from McLane Stadium. Thank you for joining us, ladies and gentlemen. You've been enjoying McLane Highlander football and Highlander Highlights, a production of the
Enjoy the show. Let's go.